Robin Williams looks 40, but he's actually 10 years old, and Jack.
David Bowie and Dennis Hopper promote the meteoric rise of the artist Basquiat.
And after the big earthquake, Kurt Russell surfs down Wilshire Boulevard in Escape from L.A.
Has a strange medical problem in Jack. He's growing at four times the normal rate, and so at the age of 10, he looks like a man of 40. And his parents wonder if he can go to regular school. I'm Gene Siskel of the Chicago Tribune.
And I'm Roger Ebert of the Chicago Sun-Times. Robin Williams has had a lot of success over the years in playing grown-up kids and other kinds of misfits, but here I think he finally runs out of luck. Jack is a movie that never seems to have really thought about what it would be like to be 10 years old and in a grown-up body. Instead, it just takes that premise and throws sitcom ideas at it. Look at this scene. One of Jack's schoolmates has talked him into impersonating the principal. Well, that's a passable comedy idea, but the way it's handled here is all wrong. This isn't a 10-year-old talking. It's Robin Williams doing one of his characters.
So tell me, what happened to Principal McGee? I just talked to him on the phone.
I don't know what happened to Mr. McGee. Mr. Powell?
He got diarrhea.
Diarrhea?
Yeah, he got diarrhea. And he spewed. Threw up. Yeah, he had the squirts. He had the diarrhea.
Oh boy, that's more than I needed to know.
And that's Fran Drescher from TV's The Nanny. Jack becomes popular with his classmates because he's big enough to buy Penthouse magazine.
And they don't give you no trouble in buying them? Like, they don't ask for ID?
No, I just don't shave for a day. I look like 50.
Only a few scenes in the movie feel like they involve a real 10-year-old inside that big adult body, and most of those scenes also involve Jennifer Lopez as his fifth-grade teacher.
What kind of foods do you just hate?
Broccoli.
Broccoli.
Makes you fart.
Anybody else here hate broccoli? Hands? Yeah.
Uh-huh. Well, it looks like you've got more in common than you think.
Jack could have been one of two things. It could have been funny or it could have been believable. For me, it was neither one. And I don't know who it was made for. Either kids are going to feel uncomfortable, I think, with the grown-up stuff, and adults won't like the slapstick and juvenile stuff. It's kind of amazing to note that Jack was directed by the great Francis Ford Coppola, who was too talented to be grinding out stuff like this.
Well, that to me is the biggest surprise of all. When I saw Coppola's name on it, mm-hmm. as the credits began, I was kind of excited. Mm-hmm. Then I was shocked, because, Roger, I can't point to a single scene in this movie and say, that's a Coppola shot. Forget about the awful screenplay that's involved. Now, it's well known that Francis Coppola just bought additional acreage for his vineyard, and he's producing wonderful wine there. Nibom Coppola, I like the 84 vintage.
Okay,
but I also have very good taste, Roger, and Jack stinks. It is really bad. And for all the reasons that you mentioned, Robin Williams is just doing his shtick, and to go into the bathos of whether Jack will survive or perish mm-hmm. is really sickening at that point. I think it's a very bad movie.
I wonder if maybe he was thinking of the success of Peggy Sue Got Married, which is about an older woman who goes back and inhabits her teenage body, and he maybe thought he could repeat that formula. But Peggy Sue had a lot of truth in it.
Oh my God.
It was about real life. It was about real feelings. This movie
and it was
is
adult.
Just,
it was adult
yes,
and
this
adult.
Movie is contrived from one end to the other. It's a real disappointment.
Tremendous disappointment. Okay. Two thumbs down, way down for Jack. My second choice of a big star in a bad movie, Robin Williams, playing a grown-up kid in Francis Coppola's disastrous Jack, the story of a child who grows so rapidly, he's an adolescent in a 40-year-old body.
So I'm big for my age.
Look. You have no hair.
I have hair. I got hair. See? Look.
Yeah, but look.
Right here, you have no hair. It looks like you're bald.
I'm not bald, and I'm not a freak. You're a freak, Four Eyes.
Robin Williams can be very annoying when he's bereft of a script, and he is left alone to, in effect, do stand-up routines. He was also not well-served by Francis Coppola, who had a better year with his vineyard, I think, making wine as opposed to movies.
Yeah, this was not a good year for vintage Coppola films. Too bad, too, because when you have people like Williams and Coppola, you want to see them doing something good. Coppola doesn't make enough movies that he has any time to waste making worthless ones.
He made the money, he bought some extra acreage, we got stuck with the picture.
He's a good director.
He's a great man.
That's a better way to put it. Okay.